One on Frozen Temple. To the bottom right hand side, we're going to start off with our blue Zerg player from CCM Gaming. It's going to be Soulkey. Haven't really casted Soulkey very much. He's someone who, well, he plays in the Lima League, but other than that, he doesn't really play in too much else. Online, really. Obviously, yeah, just kind of really just the, Lima League, and that, yeah, that's about it. That's all I can really think of, really. Yeah, so we do see him down at the bottom right. His opponent to the top left from Therese, which was at the last HomeStory Cup, is the Red Terran player top. So he's at the last HomeStory Cup, obviously enjoyed it and would like to go once again. He's going to see Arax on the wall here early on from top. So just looking to wall off straight away while he sets up into his command center. Probably just a Reaper expand then, I imagine. And as we see Soulkey just go in Hatch Gas Pool to get started in this game as well. So from both, you know, from when we look at both players' builds, we wouldn't really say anything stands out particularly just yet. But he's again set up into the earlier stages, and we'll be seeing that Reaper coming across to harass in the next couple of moments. So that's going to be coming in. And you're going to see Never Deeper coming down as well. And that Reaper about to pop out. So we're going to follow this Reaper across the map just for something to watch here early on. There's not too much else happening just yet. First few Zerglings on the way though. I mean, yeah, a few Lings are on the way, a couple of Queens on the way. But not too much past that. As that Reaper coming towards the lower right hand side. Going to run just underneath an Overlord here momentarily. And I mean, it's not as though Soulkey is not expecting a Reaper, you know? It's not as though Soulkey isn't expecting, you know, he's kind of like, you know, who doesn't go Reaper? I mean, very rarely do you see a non-Reaper build, and so Soulkey's got these lings out. He's very well prepared to deal with this, and nothing really surprising here in the very early stages of the game. Reaper and some lings, again, just dancing around. Reaper gets one kill. Was that a drone? Yes, it was. So he gets a drone kill, so that's actually quite nice getting on the drone. And we're going to be seeing the factory just coming up on the high ground. For top as well, also going to go into starport, double gas is up, so pretty much as we'd expect if he's got double gas to go into starport, he's going to drop a tech lab on the factory, and this generally leads in towards something like a kind of Widowmine base drop, and then a maybe a siege shank follow up and some harassment. It's actually really powerful on this map. A lot of people like to position over to this south side or left hand side of the third base. So if this is the third base, so they like to kind of bury the Widowmine here, attack with the Marines, and then bring the tank in and use these rocks sometimes and this ledge to their advantage. It's very, very powerful. And get a lot done. Another kill on the Reaper. You don't see what that was actually just yet. Units lost one, but he's two kills. That's interesting. He's lost two. I don't know. I'm confused. Anyway, Hatchery comes down for Soulkey. And as we see him starting up his Binner Nest. And his second speed already finished. And it's going to be seeing. I mean, right now, Top just going to come in and actually going to look to kill another drone or two. But for the most part, should just be looking to try and scout and see if there's a lair already building or anything like that. Let's try and get a rough idea of what's going on. You see the Binner Nest, which is nice. So he gets some pretty good information as to how this is going to go over the next few moments. Feelings gonna head up the right hand side. The one thing I don't like about Top building his barracks in this wall is the fact his reactor like sticks out so much. So abusable. So I first might have coming across the map here with the Widowmine and these Marines. I'm just looking to start up this aggression, probably towards the third base again is the most common sort of location for this. And we'll probably see the next medivac coming across here shortly. This Overlord in a little bit of trouble, so Soulkey gonna take some damage from this straight away. And as you're gonna see the Overlord going down, and there's that Widowmine coming into Burrow as well. Third base going to start taking some damage. A couple of Zerglings running in here already. Widowmine, ooh, probably didn't want to go off on just a couple of Zerglings like that. That's a couple of things which, well, these Marines alone probably could have dealt with if they wanted to. We're going to see more of these Marines taking more damage. We're going to see Lair about to finish, so we can see an Overseer come in to defend this as that tank sieges up. That's going to come into play now as well to keep working on this third base. Soulkey's starting to take a little bit of damage over here right now. You're going to see these Marines just working the way against this. Them Zerglings starting to run on in. You're going to see nice lift up once again. But oh, the Widowmine splashes onto the Medivac, and so the Queens shoot that down at the very end. Boom. Medivac falls. And Top loses a lot of his pressure here on this side of the map. That's unfortunate. The Widowmine splashed onto the Medivac like that, and then the Queen's able to. I mean, the Queens wouldn't have killed it. They would have got it low, but they wouldn't have been killing it. if it wasn't for that Widowmite shot. So that's unfortunate here. This top, well, I mean, back at home, he's just going in towards his third CC, extra barracks as well. I mean, he's in a good, you know, this isn't like a gotta kill the third hatch sort of build, it's just pressure. But it's a bit of a shame to lose that pressure to something like that. As we see, the Spire on the way for Soulkey, he's got a couple of Evo Chamber as well. And this Medivac and the Siege Tank just continue to be aggressive, continuing to trade here. On the natural mineral lines, just continue to move around and just working away what he can. And I mean, any kill is, or any kill, any damage, anything he forces is better than forcing nothing, of course. So, wouldn't mind finally going down there as well. That's stayed up a little longer than I thought it would. And this tank on the low ground, just gonna work its way for an extractor. And again, I mean, the Lings will run down and force a couple of Ling kills. I mean, anything is better than nothing again. Libra is actually sieged up to this right hand side, killed enough three drones already. So, Libra getting a little bit of damage done. We have an awkward spot, actually. The Queens can't really get in there. I guess they could maybe squeeze through the Evo Chambers and come in from the side, but not an easy position to get into. Soulkey not yet starting up his Sporkle at the natural either. And I guess just going to wait for his Mirrors to come out to deal with this. Mirrors also going to be a good way to deal with this Siege Tank. And getting to this point now where Top should probably start thinking about pulling this back, obviously. I mean, we know this because we see the Mirrors on the production tab. You'd imagine Top should sort of have a rough idea that Mirrors are going to be coming up at some point. So we'll see if he just overcommits here with this Siege Tank or what the case is going to be. That Queen getting very low but transfused up, so in the end not really anything Top can really get. And he does now begin to back away, especially seeing these Mirrors as they take down the Liberator. Top realizing that that's going to be the best choice. He sends a few drones, so he does back to start mining on his natural once more. And everything is just in order here. Nothing really too crazy. A couple of drones actually mined. I was going to say, well, how has he already mined out one mineral patch on the third base? But it's actually because there's a macro hash here, which is allowing slightly faster mining. Which is actually, I mean, it's a very small thing, but it's kind of nice, actually. It's just a little bit of something extra, I guess. Anyways, as we see this kind of a little bit of a push down this left-hand side, they deflect the Mutas straight away there, so Mutas not making it up towards the upper left-hand side just yet. And you see Top though with a big push coming through the center, and actually he's about 20 supply up right now. He's also got, well, he had a 1-1 upgrade lead, but the 1-1 just finishing up in up for Soulkey, which is, well, just about in time, honestly, as we see this push coming forwards. You can see the Marines killing off a Ling there on the tower, going to look to kill off another Ling to the left-hand side. That's definitely also going to... Oh, no. There we go. That's definitely also going to go down. Soulkey ready to counterattack with these few Zerglings. And Top actually not going to commit to attack, just kind of pressuring here, forcing his opponent to make some Banes or so on just to prepare, just in case he does commit. But in reality, he's just going to back away. Widowmine's on the way up now. Top, his follow-up here, Top's follow-up is kind of to go into Widowmine's instead of more tanks. Widowmine is generally a more effective way to fight against Ling, Lemuda, more mobile and so on than Siege Tanks are, so you generally go Siege Tanks for early defense and then switch into Widowmine's, exactly as Top's done. As we're going to see though, Top going to lose those first couple of mines, and these Medivacs and these Marines not doing anything at all. We do see this army very out of position. He's stimming forwards, but doesn't feel as though he can do anything about it. So Soulkey is taking away. Top had a very good position in this game. He had a lot of units he had very good timing to push with, and now he's thrown away a lot of what he had originally. He's losing a lot of his potential in this game, especially losing kind of the few medivacs, few units over to the right hand side like that. That doesn't really help him out in any way, shape, or form. Big attack from Soulkey up the right hand side once again. These Ling is still poised to counterattack if they get the opportunity to. As we'll see, Marine take the watchtower on the left hand side. There's that run by coming in. If he makes it towards the natural mineral line, that could be very deadly, and he is going to make it straight in there. So Ling's into the natural mineral line, up into the main base too. Top just going to respond to this a little bit too slow. Pulling his army back once again as well, never really committing to a fight. I don't think he wants to push down the left-hand side anyway. I think realistically he wants to push over to the right-hand side, work his way towards this fourth base. It would probably make a lot more sense. I'm going to see these Lings and Mutas and Banelings just sitting out over to the left-hand side. And these Marines just... Again, I feel like I'd like to see Top pushing towards this right-hand side base. I feel as though the right-hand side of the map is where he should put his focus onto. The left-hand side, I mean, what does he push into on the left-hand side? He has to push through so much creep before getting to the third base. And as the right-hand side, he pushes completely off of creep until he's on top of the fourth. So much potential over here. Now, this can continue to rise. Top is refusing to build Liberators. Which is, well, I mean, it happens. I mean, it depends how you like to play, and some people like to play Libras. Poor Widowmine, 15 kills. Kaboom. We're going to see these Mutas coming in. Turret going to be repaired, and actually will stay alive for a little while here, and actually will stay alive throughout. So that's really nice. Double drop over this left-hand side. Well, he's going to have to lift that and evacuate it. He does evacuate it. He'll drop off and just try and fight against the mutas instead on the low ground. So that's something. At the same time, big push into the fourth base. The top is getting something done here. He pushes into this fourth. These mutas are also fighting these marines, and they are going down. Soulkey is losing absolutely everything over here in the center. Obviously, he has a lot of Ling Bane left over, but Ling Bane, well, that's not kind of 10, 12, 15 mutalists, which he just has to replace right now. That is expensive, as we're going to see these Banes rolling in. Top loads up. He's just going to boost away from this. But what a trade from Top. Great couple of moments. Takes down not only the fourth base, but takes down so many mutalists in the middle of the map, too. 16 mutas killed throughout the game. Now, I'm not sure if there's a few mutas killed before that. I don't think there was, really. Maybe one or two to a turret that we didn't quite see. But, yeah, I mean, just a majority of them going down that fight in the middle. Soulkey just getting a little bit out of multitasked here. We're going to see a couple of Marines kind of attacking onto that Overlord. We're going to see a whole bunch of Marines pushing through the center of the map as well. We're just going to be seeing a few more Marines, pushing forward. A few Zergans going down as they run into those. I mean, Soulkey re-establishing his fourth base down to the bottom left-hand side now. So he's re-establishing down there, as we're going to see these Widow Mines slowly pushing forward. Single Widow Mine shot goes off on one Ling. Not super effective. A scan would be nice to clean up a little bit of this crew spread. Here comes some of those Lings and Banes. We're going to just push this back a bit. And actually, a lot of those Widow Mines are going off, and a lot of them, going down as well. There's still a lot of bio left over here. Overflow being pushed away as Top will take his fourth base. Soulkey's hitting a little bit of a supply block now as well. As these mutas are going to come in towards, come around. Look to trade here onto these Marines and Marauders. The Ling's looking to come in, surround. And then Bane is going to connect. Big amount of damage being done there. Nice connection with a couple of Banes at the front. As we can see, just another Marauder going down that Widow Mine too. Nice muta control. The Soulkey going into the ult. His kindness plane is on the way. Can he get there safely? Big push down the left hand side, looking to hit the fourth again. You're going to see Top just loading up, backing away, letting the Widow Mines do the work. And then pulling back, getting ready to go once more. Again, this push down the left-hand side, though, Top has a lot of potential here. Soulkey's very much so focused just towards the center. And I think, in a way, Top wants to sort of bait him forwards a little bit. He's actually going to boost away over to the right-hand side. Drop over here instead. Maybe kind of taunt Soulkey over to the right. Maybe clean up some creep. He wants to try and bring Soulkey over to the right as he pushes in towards the left-hand side in a moment. I think is his plan. As he's just going to run onto the creep spread a little bit. A few more Banes morphing in. Soulkey's not biting, though. He's not taking the bait at all. He's just sat back. So here we go, these Ling Bane's going to move forwards. And here we go, now a little bit more committed, and that's exactly what Top's waiting for, to move in towards this fourth base. Queen going to go down this fourth base under heavy fire. Is it going to go down in time? Well, Ling's are streaming in. Top is going to begin pulling back. There's an ultra popping out. No kindness playing just yet, so it is fairly weak. At this point, we're going to see the Widow Mines here. Oh my god, big connection on the Widow Mines. Time to time, these Widow Mines just connecting so well throughout the game. I mean, Soulkey, I don't think he was expecting a Widow Mine here with this kind of bio army. Is very well set up by Top. Like, he set up them Widow Mines a long time ago, so it looks as though he never kind of arrived with Widow Mines. He waited for the perfect moment to move in. He did kill a fair amount. And as we see, these Mutas just going to come in and clean up those medevacs. And that's Top actually losing quite a lot of supply on those medevacs. He needs to keep his money low, his money rising up quite a bit right now. Some Liberators on the way and the Ghost Academy on the way down to help him deal with these Ultralisks right now as well. As we're going to see, these ultras coming up the right-hand side. These Zerglings starting to run on in as well. Plenty forwards to set up at the fourth base, though. So Soulkey not necessarily able to break this position. A few more Lings and Banes in production. So here we go. These Marines Marauders has to be a little bit careful, as this Plenty Fortress is going to be under attack here. Marines Marauders are going to be running in, just going to be fighting against these ultras. And actually, these Marines Marauders doing a very good job. A few Banes connecting, though. Has to be careful of those. I mean, ultras do die when there's nothing else to kind of go along with them, when there's nothing to support them, and we saw very quickly how one died very swiftly just then. Soulkey, 15 supply down, is down in upgrades as well. Doesn't have to start as the next Carapace upgrade, though. Starting to catch up. Gonna take him just a little while here. You see two medivacs just loading up, moving over to the left-hand side. As we're gonna see these few overseers moving around, and these commuters. We're gonna see what they might get up to as well. Hatchery down to the far bottom left is, well, not going to be fine actually by Top. He looks like he wants to unload. He's going to fly right onto the fourth base. A little bit risky. He sees an ultra here. He's just going to back away. Mutas off because he's going to be in a quick response, basically. Mutas is going to come in and just chase this down. Ultra's on the way in too. I mean, these Marines The medevacs not long for the world. They decided to drop somewhere, which was not a smart place to drop. Flying over the fourth base without the load was a very risky move, and he pays the price for it. So against Soulkey, well, defense that drop fairly okay. I mean, I was going to say continues with the fairly decent drop defense, but quite honestly, his drop defense has been somewhat lackluster. I mean, one of the drops he traded, he lost 14 meters or something to, and another drop kind of led him to being kind of pushed and attacked, and losing the base and all sorts. So we've seen a mixture of good, of successful and unsuccessful defenses of drops in this game from Soulkey. That was one of the more successful ones, I guess. Lots of ghosts coming out here for top as, well, Corruptor's starting to build up for Soulkey, getting into them ultras as well. Just getting into this late game Zerg army, just starting to build up his composition. As he gets a bit more economy and kind of doesn't have to replace as much or build up the ultras and so on, he'll start to add on a couple of infestors and so on too. Top though, just, I mean, his army's looking good as well. It's late game Terran, Liberator and Ghosts all set up, ready to go. Another Liberator coming out, going to be over this army in a moment or so. And they're just going to be watching these couple of medevacs moving over to the right hand side here. So you're just going to be seeing the medevacs just once again trying to drop, and actually this time might be fairly successful. Most of the army for Soulkey currently over to the left hand side. Both armies kind of seeing each other on the edge of their vision for a moment or two there. I mean, Soulkey doesn't want to fight until his next set of upgrades finishes, which is just going to be in a couple of moments. As you see, medevacs boosting on in towards this natural base. Now, I was just talking about upgrades. NA&LAM&SEA chambers might go down. That would be a big kickoff as well. Top going to lift up. Oh my god, is that Clarapest going to go down? Is it going to finish? Finishes. Wow, Soulkey is very, very fortunate here. Top, he could have killed that if he left both his medevacs over there. Instead, he flies one away to just go down immediately. This base over here is in a little bit of trouble, as we're going to see. Some Liberators doing some good damage. Actually, Snipes to be able to come down as well. These Ultras are just going to disappear in a moment or two. Snipes do a lot of damage to the Ultras, guys. We're going to see Top pushing his lower left-hand base. A few more Snipes coming in as well. Once again, and a few more just to finish off here. So then last two Ultras going down as well. He is coming in, but they just can't realistically fight without anything next to them. And Top does break this bottom left-hand base. Medivac in the main. His Marines in this have been cleaned out. The Medivac's still standing. So obviously not can't do too much with that, as we're going to see Mew's looking to counterattack across the map, but a couple of Liberators, a couple of Ghosts. Well, I'm going to come in. I mean, the Mew's obviously can trade against these Ghosts though, but not super well. Ghosts actually jump into the bunker. Every day see a Ghost in the bunker, and actually they do turn those Mew's away, so Mew's get turned away, and obviously seeing this opportunity, I'm just going to see Top continue to push forwards. However, nice Fungal Grove's catching a lot of this bio. He's going to be forced to pull back right now, so pulling back, only really Marauders left over. A few Marines over here are going to go down as well. As we'll see, Top just pulling away. Sonder kind of drop his natural expansion over here in this location. Looking to keep on pushing down this left-hand side and in towards the fourth base of his opponent right now, which is situated over here. Pretty much the only mining base left for Soulkey. Mined out over here. His natural has a few minerals left in it, and actually probably be worth sending a few of his drones from this third over to that natural. And his main base too, you could saturate a little bit more too. Single Zergling moving forwards and gonna go down. As we see, well, actually, being attacked, it's all coming in from Soulkey. Huge Snipes already coming down here onto these Ultralisks. And, well, the Liberator is doing an okay job of cleaning up, and this sort of leaves more than anything the Corruptors left in the sky. Soulkey gonna realize he can't break this position, he's lost too much. That right there is gonna be GG. Top takes game number one. Anything interesting? As we have to the upper right hand side on Dusk Towers, our blue Zerg player from TCM. It is going to be Soulkey. Down again now in this best of three. And to the bottom left, it's going to be our red town player from Tree Esports. Let's see it, guys, if you're cheering on. Top. Up one game. Having a pretty fantastic time for himself so far. It was pretty. He was kind of at an advantage early in that game, and then lost a couple of drops without doing anything, and then had a successful attack, and then had a crappy attack, and very back and forth, but always seemed as though Top just had a little bit of an advantage though throughout. It seems as though Top had an advantage, Soulkey evened it up. Top took an advantage again. Soulkey never seemed to be the one who's kind of dictating the pace of the game. I mean, at one point you had a run by, but that was about, you know, that's probably the most successful thing Soulkey did. That's probably the one time we really saw Soulkey on his opponent's side of the map, so just going to be seeing this setting up game number two right now. Top again, one game up, and Soulkey hatch fists on the low ground. Just going to get that crisp spread moving out onto the map a little bit earlier on here than he would if he took his in-base natural. setting up with that, and yeah, you're going to see a spawning pool dropping down as well from Soulkey. And that rack's going to finish. Just a Reaper expand coming in, so pretty much the same as last time. Nothing really to talk about just yet. We'll see if the Zerg wants to do something a little bit different, kind of change things up. Keep mining gas past 100, going to maybe a fast lair or something, fast Mutas, maybe fast Nidus. A lot of different possibilities here. So let's have a
look to see. Ooh, sorry.
Yeah, my sleeping schedule doesn't really agree with the start time of this qualifier, to be quite honest. So sorry for a little bit of a yawn there, guys. Sometimes they just sneak through. I really just need like a Red Bull or something, but I don't have any in my house anymore. I really need to see next time I go. There's like a cheap shop next to. I don't know what to call, like how to call it. I can't even remember what it's called myself. It's like a really cheap shop, and it's next to the gym.
Looks like I go. I have to stop off and
get some Red Bulls. I don't have Red Bulls for ages, actually. I'm gonna see the Reaper here just trading with these Zerglings. Soulkey has continued to mine gas here now. You know, once upon a time we'd be like, all in! Nowadays we'd be like, well, maybe fast lair, maybe just Nubitized Carapace, and it is gonna be the Nubitized Carapace as the choice of player here from Soulkey at the start of this game, so Nubitized Carapace on the way down. I'm just going to be seeing Soulkey working his way through these rocks down the low ground here. So, just working his way through this, as we're going to see the Reaper. He's just going to be scanning around, just trying to pick up some information. He's no third base just yet. But again, I mean, if he comes in towards the main, I guess he's not really going to find that Nubitized Carapace, really. It's hard to know whether that's a Queen build or Nubitized Carapace, so just going to be trying to look around. I mean, he sees no lair, though, which is important, so he knows it's not a lair on the way, at least. So I'm just going to escape down here, but that's our second speed kicking in, and that will be that. So overload speed now into the game, and we're going to be seeing the overload just coming in. So in a moment here, top will realize what's going on. We'll know he doesn't have to be too worried about some kind of attack, as these overloads are going to be coming into spot. Soulkey turns this one away almost immediately as the Marines begin to chase it down. Good stir step, Micro. Kills it off there, and that goes down. Another overload over here will back away after seeing that third CC on the way up. Hatchery in the top right corner is on the way for Soulkey, so that'll be his third hatchery now. And again, this is why he takes the hatchery on the low ground to begin with, because it just lets him get that creep spread so much further out. I mean, you know, you look at this creep, you imagine it started over here, it'd be barely breaking out of this ramp right now. Instead, it's moving out onto the map already, so that's really nice. This medevac can be spotted by that overlord, and I mean, top just at this point in time looking to just try and apply a little bit of pressure. I mean, there's no real position that you can kind of abuse as well on this map as you can on Frozen Temple with this wooden mine base drop, like we saw him doing that last game. So he's going to look to see if he can pick off a couple of workers, maybe get a good Widowmine hit or so, as he's going to be moving on in. Maybe just try and drop off into the natural, but again, not really. You know, he doesn't have ledges to work with and all of that space here on Dusk Towers, like he does on Frozen Temple. Widowmine, just going to unburrow. Not going to go off on that Zergling. There's the Reaper just burrowing in. Marines just going to start unloading over on the natural expansion as the Marines is going to be trading their way against it. Liberator. No, I'm sorry, not a Liberator, but a drop in towards the main base now, actually. Not really going to do very much. A single Marine poor guy left behind as that medevac retreats. He does spot the Spire, but no real damage being done here, although into the third base we go. A few drones being pulled away now, and he's just going to wrap around, clean that up, and again, top just kind of dropping here while setting up in towards his 3cc, in towards his extra barracks, and just into corners, sort of his mid-game in general. There's that Liberator. So actually, I mean, overall, this is a, fairly, like, standard sort of, it's just fairly standard, really, isn't it? I mean, pretty much the same as what we saw in Frozen Temple, just it plays out a lot differently, so, let's see that Liberator picking that off. And we're going to see this medevac from top is going to be moving around as well. Very much Corona Boy for your $5 donation. I'll read out your message after the game when I can check it. Can I get some testy hearts in the chat, please? And make it a lot of them, because Corona Boy hit us off with a big donation last night when the stream went offline. Oh, I just wasn't able to shout out on the stream. He was up with $100, so some SGI hearts in the chat, please, for Corona Boy right now. Let's see some love for a great guy who is a heavy supporter of the stream. Thank you very much, dude. I'm SGI hearting right now, but obviously you can't see me. 1-1 upgrades on the way for both players. Soulkey and Top are just setting up into this 1-1 set of upgrades apiece. We see 14 lings on the way from Soulkey, 4 Moodalisks on the way up for Soulkey as well. And that hatchery just coming down over on the 4th base over to the right hand side. So 4th base just on the way over to the right. And a few overlords just moving out and getting into position here as these Marines, Medivacs, the Liberator getting set to attack into this 4th. A few bins on the way in. I mean, Silky's gone into just mismutiling being composition. Nothing really too crazy about this at all as these Marines are stemming forwards here. They're going to take down that 4th base. I'm really struggling with some of my words today. I mean, earlier I couldn't say, I can't remember what I couldn't say, but it was like peach flavored juice. I couldn't say that. I can't say it now. So yeah, apologies. As we see these medevacs just going to lift, and it looks as though they're just going to try and evacuate here. Just trying to get away before they get caught by the Ling Bane. They are going to make it for the most part away, but the Mirs are on their way down to intercept, and medevacs is going to have to unload here instead. And Mirs will take a little bit of damage, not too much. And obviously this army just going to be a little bit trapped down there, which is a little bit unfortunate. Maybe if Soulkey can take a fight in the next couple of moments, it could be very good, because there's a lot of supply which is just sort of missing off over to this side. As we're going to see the Mirs coming in. Plenty of Marines dropping down though, and that Liberator helping a little bit with the damage there as well. A single Moodalisk going down. You're going to see Marines and Banelings, Lings and Banelings moving forwards here. There's Moodalisk coming in too. Still love the army for Top, kind of stuck down to that bottom right side. Widowmines though, getting really good connections here, and a lot of these Banes going down actually. And so Top is able to defend Soulkey, not taking a good fight. Now imagine that was a fight where actually, you know, Top has these units in the game as well. Top can actually now send these out across the map to harass once again, going towards that 4th base. And so this is really nice for Top. That was a very successful fight for him. And now actually Soulkey has no Banelings on the map, and so this drop over here, well, that's just almost guaranteed to get damage done. And you're going to see him starting to unload, and more Marines coming across the map too. Marines are going to stem, so the Marines are out of position. 4th base goes down once more, is cancelled again. As we will see, these Mutas continuing to move around and look to see what is going on. As we're going to see these Marines is going to be staming, these Lings and Mutas are going to be running on in here. Tank goes down, and actually, well, Soulkey doesn't do as well as Top doesn't do as well here as I thought he would. But I guess at the very end, he just cleaned out a lot of these Banes. He's also got to push up through the center, clean out a lot of creep spread. Big push here. Now a lot of creep tumors. He's gonna just lift up and leave now as well. Reinforcements still coming in from Top. He's got so much money in the bank. If he spent that, he'd be so far up on supply. But he doesn't spend it, so he isn't so far up on supply as he maybe should be. And we're gonna have a few extra racks on the way down. Going to be seeing a couple of Winter Mines burrowing here as well. A few Marines just unloading to the top side. These Lings are on the way through those rocks though, looking to get access to where these drops are currently hiding. There's a 4th base on the way for Top. It's 2-2 about to kick in, as is Soulkey. So upgrade's still very even here in this kind of Mutaling Bane, Bio Mine kind of composition. So we're going to see a few more Marines, a couple of Marauders coming out, and these Marines here just trying to trade against the Lings for a moment or two. Going to start boosting away. Actually going to start trading with the Mutals a little bit more again, and I mean, obviously, there's not too much he's going to do with this, so, I mean, just get a bit of damage from the Mutas. It's better than nothing. I mean, okay, it'll regen, but you never know. As these Mutas continue to fly around. 11 more Banes being morphed in. We're going to see a plus one flyer attack is on the way in as well. I'm just going to be seeing a few more Banelings on the way up. We're going to see a whole bunch of Marine Marauder out for Top. Again, just... it feels like he had such a good opportunity earlier, and then he kind of lost it a bit because he didn't spend his money and didn't get as strong an attack as he could have. And by missing that opportunity, he misses a lot of his kind of, he just kind of loses a bit of his advantage in the game now in more of an even state than maybe an advantage for him. As we are going to see, one Mir goes down and everyone getting very low in this main base as he picks away at reactors and so on. He's forced the Marines to stim around after him, and well, that's natural. She has no turret defense at all, so the Muse is going to have a bit of a field day here until the Marines catch up. And the Muse is just going to back away up the left-hand side here. So he's going to back away. He's going to see these turret will be repaired, and actually a couple of Muse go intact to that turret. Turret picking up two kills there, sniping down them low-health Mutalisks. As we do see the Plan V Fortress morphing in at the 4th base, and there's a few Marines up to the top side from top as well. And a few Mutas just sat over to the left. We're going to see those moving out here for Soulkey. And just going to be, again, looking to see what they can get up to. So continue moving around with Mutas and looking to see what exactly he can achieve. As we see the Hive going to be finishing up here shortly from our Zerg player. He's finally got that 4th base established. I mean, he lost that a couple of times on the way. And we're going to be seeing the 5th base also on the way down now for Soulkey too. As he moves around with these Mutalisks. And again, just looking to kind of, I mean, both players still on just their mid-game armies. At this point, I guess Top might just be waiting to kind of keep deflecting Mutalisks. And then when his next set of upgrades kicks in, he takes an upgrade lead. That might be when he tries to attack here, just before Ultras are going to come into the game, so. Let's see, this Ling Bane going to pull back a little bit. A few more Bane Lings morphing in. And as these Furious of Banes morph in, we're going to see them joining up with the rest of the Zerglings and Banelings over here. And Overseer is going to start morphing in as well from Soulkey. So he's going to start morphing that in as these Mutas come forwards. And just going to be having a little bit of a look to see what they might be able to get up to. As these Mutas are. Again, going to be in a little bit of trouble because there's Liberators here. 4-2, they have to be really careful, especially if they stack up. I'm just going to see one Baneling out the front. That's not going to do anything at all. Scan to sort of clean up a little bit of crew spread. Again, this is the sort of map that's very difficult to attack on as well. That's not a lot of Banelings to really attack here from Soulkey at all. He's morphing in a lot more. He's actually got a lot more further back, so it's kind of weird. I think in the way we might just see Top not really being able to push through at all. We might just have to start going for late game. And it's, again, a very hard map to attack on. And, well, we do see Soulkey going to start coming in for the fight. We're actually going to see a big fight here. Lings and Banelings starting to crash on through. We're going to see a lot of Winterbines starting to go off, a lot of Banes left over, and they're still rolling forwards, cleaning up Marines and all sorts in the back, and Soulkey going to take a commanding fight here, and a huge lead in this game as, well, we're going to see Medivacs going down as well. The Mutas will give chase, and as they run out of boost, that'll be the Medivacs being able to be chased, but actually the Mutas pull back. So the Medivacs do get away, but enough units here realistically for Soulkey to just run in and trade, I think. He's going to think twice about it, though. The thing is, when he's so close to Ultralisks, is it really worth him committing to a fight? Right, you know, is that really worth him committing to another fight when he could wait for Ultras and have a stronger fight and still a similar lead in just a couple of moments? So, I don't think it's worth him committing. I think it's the right decision to wait a couple of moments, at least for one or two Ultras, which will just make life so much more difficult for our Terran player. Mutas coming in, the Sniper Widowmine. Good Mutas count so far still. Of course, they're going to go down very quickly as the Liberator count rises, so he has to be a bit cautious of that. Obviously, after this first set of Ultras, we're generally expecting, most likely, the Corruptors to start coming into play. So the Medivac drop, unable to do too much here. And Soulkey going to start attacking on in. And Liberators are sieged up, and so there's no shade, you know, there's no fear for these Mutas to just kind of run on in. And the Sniper goes down. A little bit of the Lings, a few of the Lings going down. Not all the Ultras here just yet, so Soulkey's going to back away towards his creep spread, which has been pushed quite far back from the initial, from the previous push by Top. This creep all the way back, you know, onto his own half of the map even, so pulling back from that as we do see this Medivac. So moving around over here, that's going to be picked off as well. So again, Soulkey, this time around, it's just really not slipping up at all. He's been, lost his fourth base a couple of times, but has definitely been very much so on top of his drop defense. Hasn't really allowed that to do too much apart from a couple of cancels on the fourth base. Which happens, and I mean, in a way, he kind of took a fight that was a bit bad as well, but apart from that, we're going to see Soulkey just kind of being very commanded in this game. Top just setting up defensively once again as Soulkey looks to get into a position he can attack into. He's going to go for this, here we go. Widowmine going to start off with a connection, which also splashes onto a whole bunch of units as Widowmine is actually continuing to clean up a little bit as well. Ghost coming in trying to snipe, but there's not enough snipes quite yet to actually start dealing with this amount of Ultralisks. The Ultras are going to start working their way through the planetary force. We're going to see a repair starting to come down. But more snipes coming in as well. Another Ultra falls. And another Ultra going to be chased away. Top loses a lot, but pushes Soulkey back. And stays alive for now. And honestly, I mean, on Dusk Towers, you might be behind. You know, if you're behind, but you can set up defensively a bit, Well, then you might be able to just stay in the game a while longer than you maybe should. You can see these mutas and Ultra's going to turn around and start fighting once again, though. And Top overcommits. He doesn't sit in his defensive position. So he's going to start losing quite a lot over here. That fall goes down. A couple more Liberators coming out. Those mutas about to fall. They're on very low health. They're going to go down and have a couple of shots. And Soulkey knows this. He's trying to pull them away, trying to minimize the damage he takes. Another snipe comes down. Another Ultra falls. And Soulkey really not taking the best trades in the last couple of moments. And Top is defending. The Planet 4 is helping him a lot. The couple of Ghost Snipes coming down. Getting rid of those Ultras very, very quickly, so Soulkey has to be careful here. He also lost the rest of his Mutas too, to then a couple of Liberators that came out, so now Soulkey's sat in a position where, well, he's got a few Ultras and he's got a few Corruptors, but that's about it. A few Zerglings too are moving forwards. And he's just going to be seeing him attempting to push on in towards this base once again. A couple more Snipes coming down. These Ultras are going to start falling here very quickly. The Corruptors don't have anything to actually target just yet. But, they're going to cause to spray down this planetary. Is there a repair in time? I don't think there is. Fourth base goes. And that's a big move by Soulkey. Finally getting something a little bit more kind of substantial achieved here in this game. Than just kind of consistently throwing units at kind of a position which he never gains anything from. He gains a bit of supply advantage, but not much else. But now he kills off the fourth base. So a lot of SCVs that have to long distance mine, we're actually going to soon see the natural, well, the main base lifting up and moving into that fourth. The problem with that is, of course, that we've seen the planet before, it's actually been somewhat useful here, but now that's not going to be the case, and so going to make it a bit harder for Top to defend than he may want it to be. As these Corruptors coming over to his left-hand side, they see a Liberator, I mean, they could think about firing, but a couple of Snipes going to come down. Snipes come down anyways and kill off a Corruptor, get another one very low. Imagine the snipe just did enough to kind of one-shot Corruptor, that'd be so sick. Instead it takes two snipes, or one snipe and a little bit of damage from elsewhere. Which is generally enough anyway, I mean, especially if you've got Liberators, I guess you get some splash done. You don't really need much else. We're gonna see a few more Ultras coming in, we're gonna see the Corruptors starting to work their way through that orbital. And these SCVs starting to go down too. Top supply is, well, looking a little bit depressing right now, it's down to just 72. Soulkey is, 100 supply ahead. Pretty simply, we're gonna see the fungal growth starting to come down. Starting just to help to clean up these bio units. Just locking them in position as we're going to see Corruptors kill off the base to the right hand side. They're not over here to kind of kill off the Liberators just yet. Planty once again, can it be the savior? And the Corruptors go down, so there's no Liberator. Liberators go down to the Corruptors now. Another sniper comes in from the Ghost. We're going to see caustic spray. That Planty will go. And again, I mean, Top is more or less beaten out of this game. We're going into game number three here between Soulkey and Top in this TVZ series. In the winner bracket. Well, we'll see how it goes. Anyways, just gonna mention that as we jump into game number three now. Tied up one game apiece, we're going to Prion Terraces for our third and final game. To the upper left-hand side of the map from TCM, it's gonna be our blue Zerg player. Let's hear it, guys, if you're cheering on Soulkey. To the bottom right is gonna be our red town player from True Esports. It is gonna be Top. So, Top, he kind of did what he did on Frozen Temple, which is just walling off of the barracks, kind of at his natural ramp. I mean, this is a map where Free Rack Sweeper is oftentimes used. We'll see if he puts down another Raxi in a moment. I don't think he will. I think he's just going to play an expansion. And so, the kind of wall at the front just to help him wall off safely early on. Nothing really to say about it. Just, you know, that's what it is. So, we'll see him setting up into this once again. Pretty much as we, saw him setting up on Frozen Temple, and pretty much as we saw him setting up on Dusk Towers too. So probably looking for a Ripper Expand here in the very early stages of this game. Man, it's a little bit chilly again today. It's a little bit cold. Let me just put my hoodie on, guys. It's just a little bit cold in here. I think it's colder than usual in my room because my dad's not here. My dad's not here today, and he wasn't here yesterday, and he's not here today, and so his like computers aren't turned on. I think that actually adds to a lot of warmth in this room usually. So I'm not used to it being just a little bit nippy. That being said, it's usually warmer in here, but then it's usually got the windows wide open as well. So I mean, you gain one thing, you lose another. All right, so. As Ripper begins to move across the map from Top to have a little bit of a look to see what is going on here in the early stages. Just going to be moving across right now with this Ripper to have a look to see what is happening. This Reaper just going to be popping up and just going to start trading here on the gold base. Whoops, drone flying a little bit there as that grenade comes in. Always find it funny when the drones like gets blown towards like delivering its missiles. It like flies through the air, it's like waving its little wings around like it's in trouble. It's sort of funny. You've got to kind of pay attention to it. It doesn't happen all the time, and it's just sort of funny when it does happen. It's usually when it's mining and you kind of hit it and like you hit it straight, so it's like you hit it towards this base while it's kind of returned minerals or something. And it's just the way the animations link up or something makes it kind of go slow-mo. It's kind of funny. Neighbor Test Carapace build once again from Soulkey, so starting up that Overlord speed, looking to get some information here early. Pretty much the exact same as what we saw from him in game number 2 just then on Dusk Towers. Prime Towers, I mean, these maps are all maps which are kind of, if you survive, kind of, especially on, well, okay, I guess on Prime Terraces, you got to survive the gold base. But if you survive the gold base, it's a very good map, once again, to go late game on. I mean, you can, you know, defend up 3-4 bases very easily. You've got very good natural, you know, expansions to continue taking. The expansion pathways are very easy to kind of flow along. So it's, a lot of, potential here, basically, for, TVZ to go into the later stages once again. We've seen two very good games so far between these two players, and hopefully that continues into game number 3. This Reaper is going to be hopping on up. I'm just again having a little bit of a look to see what's going on. Grenade going to pop down and just going to blast those drones around a little bit as those Zergans run on in. And that Reaper going to go down. And that third hatchery just coming up over to the left hand side. So third hatch on the way from Soulkey, as we see this Overlord for Soulkey just moving around as well. I'm just scouting here early on. Just having a look to see what's happening. Just to see the third CC is he doesn't go into the natural. Well, that's probably what this Overlord's here to do. Go into the natural, have a look around. I mean, the thing is, Soulkey sees a lack of, you know, 400 minerals because he doesn't see any extra racks building. And so, some, you know, he's got to realize, like, something is, you know, third CC has to be somewhere. All of this, some racks he hasn't found as well. And to be fair, I mean, there's a big kind of empty spot in his vision in the natural. So he should figure out that's where this base is. As you see, a bit of a drop coming over here. That Widow Maya actually unloading and getting a shot off on a few Zerglings to begin with, and some damage being done onto this hatchery once again already. A few Zerglings running in. They're going to start going down. Can't really attack in on their own like that. There's another Ling going down here, and obviously on the way up top, defend the lair is already finished here for Soulkey. You're going to see a lift and a very fast Spire coming down for him as well, and also following that up with double Evo Chambers. So a couple of Evo Chambers, Spire, all coming up here as we see. Now the tank actually on the low ground too. More Marines as well. Sorry, a little bit of a black spike there on my screen. There's just going to be just going to be seeing the Widow Mine coming in. I'm just going to be getting killed off there. But tank is sieged up on the low ground now. And so, again, I mean, top is doing quite a bit of damage. There's a few Lings on the low ground getting some damage onto their tank. The tank will have to lift up now and drop back down once again. But look at this damage that top is doing. He's doing so much right now. As we're going to see the Marines moving forward, picking off another Queen, another drone going to go down as well, and a couple of Lings also going down as we see, again, this tank going to have to be lifted, top, just saving it there, just about in time. Still so many Marines over here, drones going to be pulled into this too, that tank being lifted once more, Marines going to lift now as well, he's going to drop behind the minerals and try and get into a bit of a better position where he's kind of a little bit less, you know, a little bit more choked up and a little bit less kind of just completely surrounded. As you see this, couple of medevacs just going to be pushed away eventually, but top gets some good damage done, kills so much here early on, 1400 resources lost for Soulkey to the 400 of his own. So top really getting a lot done with this, and this tank's still going to just kite around and just get a couple more Zergan kills here towards the end. Cosman2, thank you very much for your $5 donation. Again, I'll read your message out after the game when I can check it. Thank you very much for the support and the donation. So message our hearts in the chat please for Cosman and his $5 donation. These two medevacs are returned back home now for top. So, I mean, so much done and so little lost as well as the moon. You know, he lost a Widow Mine, he lost a handful of Marines. I mean, so little in comparison to the damage he got done. Now, we do see Mutas coming out for Soulkey. So, Soulkey going to start pushing down. This, well, pushing through the center of the map, I guess, with these Mutas. Going to start looking to harass. However, top is, well, actually, top hasn't got missile turret set up. So, he's not ready immediately to deal with these Mutas at all. And so he's going to start taking some damage. Widow Mines, Mutas are going to cancel some of these turrets which are coming in. Actually going to kill one there. Kills a couple of SCVs so far as well. Obviously, Soulkey looking for some damage after the damage he took on his own side of the map. And he's going to force a cancel there too on a reactor. And Oh man, he's killing off so much here. These mutas are getting so much damage done straight away. Obviously, a lot of this is just cancels, but it really slows the Terran's production down. And that's definitely one way in which Soulkey can just sort of fight back into this game. Mew's going to find themselves a medevac now as well, and Top not going to realize that in time, so Soulkey's Muta control this game. Well, not necessarily Muta control, but his Muta harassment has been very, very effective. Doing so much to pull himself back into this from what was definitely an early deficit. He's pulled himself back 600 resources so far just with these Mutalisks. And he's not stopping there. He's going to loop around and look for another couple of SCVs. Or maybe, I mean, Armory is something he can target, I guess. Slow down the 2-2 from starting. I mean, that'd be that's potentially quite useful because we see the 2-2 is doing the start, but just going to force another Armory. And an Armory is expensive, man. I mean, it's a lot of resources to rebuild. It's like, what, 150, 150? It's like 300 resources going down right there, and he has to rebuild it for his 3-3, maybe not immediately, but at some point, so it is still eventual damage. And as the Mutas do see, the army is over to the left-hand side. These Overlords actually right out in the middle as well. They're going to start going down, which is going to be a little bit of a shame for Soulkey. He actually only loses one, as his push continues to move on up here. A few Banelings are already ready to go, and a few more Morphin in, just to make sure he's got enough. Mutas going to join up as well to help out with this defense. Going to see, well, Lingus and Bane is going to start streaming on forwards. Mew's going to target the tank down to the left-hand side. The Lingus and Bane army is going to get a real good amount of damage done over here as well. And he's going to clean out a lot of this. A few Marines and a Marauder left over. Mew's could go clean that up if they want. It looks as though Soulkey isn't maybe aware that there's a few units left there. Maybe he was just looking elsewhere, already confident that he had cleaned this up. These few Marines and the Marauder for Top just pulling back towards these Marines and the four over here. Let's see a gold base on the way up to the right hand side and another base on the way up for Top 2, so more gold bases just sort of join up. As you can see, those mutas gonna get turned away and just gonna pull in towards the main base as well. Just gonna start working the way against the turret. So, and again, this muta harassment has been the real downfall for Top this game. He got so much early, but then it's just again fallen apart throughout to the mutalisk harassment. Fifth base on the way up for Soulkey to the top right hand side of the map. So he's continuing to expand, continuing to set up over here as he pulls away from the Mutalisks. Once again, just comes in, gets a little bit of damage done, backs away as the Marines come to respond. Top also sent up into his fourth base here. He did take his third base at the gold, so he got away with that, which is nice. It's a little bit more susceptible to run by, etc., but he's able to be, you know, he's been able to hold this, so that's been great for him. Obviously, with the damage he did earlier, it's no surprise that he got that set up and ready to go, as we're going to see. These Mutas are going to run in, they're going to pick off a SCV there. As these Marines are going to take a little bit of damage too. And a few of those are starting to fall down. Mew's going to back off though. And Command Center going to be lifting. And moving on over to the 4th base as well. So the medevac's going to be loading on up. And obviously we're going to see some drop play starting to come into play for Top. So he's going to start dropping around, as we're going to see these Mew's just heading on over to the right hand side. So he's just hoping to head on over to the right-hand side, as we're going to see these couple of medevacs just heading up to the top right side. So before this action continues, let's have some SCI hearts in the chat, please, for Legomaster 666 for the Freeman for reserve. Thank you very much for the continued support. And we're going to see a few Marines dropping off, just going to unload just behind this watchtower. Here we go. Link's going to start running in. Mew's going to run in too. Mew's taking a lot of damage, though. It's a very good position for these Marines with the kind of wall-off being created, or the choke points being created thanks to the watchtower. That's really, really nice, and so Top trades pretty well there and kills off 3 or 4 Mutalisks as well. So really nice trade for him overall. As we're going to see Marines and Day 4 just setting up over here, and then Overlord's going to go down as well. 4th base for Top. It's going to be established, so it's definitely been kind of a tough few minutes for him while he's been trying to deal with all these Mutalisk harassings and whatever, and, you know, all of that, but he is sort of, you know, keeping himself in this. He's making sure to keep himself in this, as we're going to see a bit of mine coming forwards. The couple of ghosts moving forwards as well right now too. So everything just joined up together just between these couple of turrets. I see adrenal glands is on the way, and we also see +3/+3 on the way as well for Top right now. As for Soulkey right now, both players actually also 3/3 on the way for Top 2. So both players going to their final set of upgrades in this game. Top already preparing for late game as well. Lots of ghosts on the way out. Lots of ghosts on the way out. He's going into some Liberator production now as well. So that's to deal with these Mutas, which throughout have just been finding so much damage. And this is why we generally nowadays just see the you generally nowadays you just see the sort of Mutalisks, they don't get this much done because we see actually Terran players going into kind of six Liberators or so early in the game. It's not necessarily a bad thing because it helps out a lot kind of deflecting the Mutas, and it helps out a lot when the Ultras first come out. So that's what we generally see. But that's not been what Top has chosen to do, and so because of that, we've actually ended up seeing Soulkey here just sort of, well, losing out throughout. I mean, he's been missing out on quite a lot. Is Ling Bane going to collect together over to the right-hand side? We're going to see a few more Banes morphing in as Ultras getting ready to push down into this base. Top just says, you know what? Nah, I'm done. don't fancy it. Don't fancy holding this base anymore. I've mined enough from here. He's just going to back away. So he feels like he's mined enough. I guess he can land over here if he wanted to. There's lots of places he could land. That's CC. We're going to see him setting up. I mean, he's very defensive setup. Soulkey is going to just attack on through, though, apparently. He doesn't care. Here he goes. Soulkey pushing on in. A couple of Widowmines starting to go off, getting some good damage initially. A few Banelings still rolling in towards those Marines at the front. Goes to start sniping down Ultras, but not before a lot of Marines are going down in this fourth base. Well, that looks as though that's going to fall here. These Mutas getting rid of a lot of these SCVs. Ghost going down too, and Soulkey. A very simple fight. In fact, it's almost as though Soulkey throughout this series has just become better and better at ZvT, because game number one, he really struggled.